day 8, H for dash, and I'll tell you what H4 is, and I'm sure I want you to guess what H4 is at the end of it all. Day 8, H4, and we are doing boot camp for superstar lawyers. Hi. How is it going? Day 0? Losers, I think we should start with day 0 again, because I know, except for one or two, nobody's even remembering what was day 0. Day 0 was sleeping early at night. That's not happening with most of you, all of you. Therefore, you will not be able to day 1, which is A for alarm. That's not going to happen. And because A for alarm is not happening, B for books is not happening, C for compose is not happening, D for do's and don'ts, I think you must have toyed with that cafe, coffee day, tissue paper, you must have written 2-3 do's and don'ts. E for elocution is not happening, F for finance is not happening, you're blowing all the money. So there's no meaning in doing day 8 for most of you losers. But then again, hopefully there is a winner amongst you who will remember all of these mantras and do some justice with it. Day 8, H4 dash. Let's see if you have you played dumb charade? Like, you know, two people, one party. You know that dumb charade game where one party gets up and says, guess the name of the movie. Okay. Then the other person says heat, hot, sun, barish. Yeah. Bobby Deol. I'm from the old era. Okay. And Ujada Chaman, Bala, Dumb Charade. So I'm going to play some Dumb Charade with you just to keep you interested. You know, when you get up in the morning, we have spoken about this, there is this legendary Navy Marine who gets up in the morning, and we get up in the morning and you just move on. I was just having a word with my colleagues, and if there are men amongst you, Indian men, you are entitled. Your bedsheet is folded by your mummy for the first 25, 26, 28 years of your life. If you're a late bloomer and you get married after 30, then after that it's folded by your wife. Okay. When you get up in the morning, alright, if you do this, you're going to feel good. Trust me, it's magical. Like, it's one of those babas, you know, who say that pani puri khale na sab theek ho jayega. ठीक है चूरन खा लेना सब ठीक हो जाएगा और कांदा भजे खाना सब ठीक हो समथिंग लाइक दैट यू नो यू जस्ट टेक दिस एंड यू डोंट डू दिस नाउ दिस इज व्हाट यू डू टेक अ स्वीट टाइम सो अर्ली मॉर्निंग इट्स 5 o'clock डे 1 इट्स अ बिट बोरिंग माय शो आई कांट डू सपना चौधरी टू टिटिलेट यू डे 1 दिस इज यू बाय द वे दिस इज यू गोइंग टू बी डूइंग दिस टुमारो मॉर्निंग H4. See, time is passing slowly. We're not in a hurry. We've got all the time in the world. Because if I can't do this well, what will I do in the rest of the day that will be well? You see? Please forgive my dress. It's going all down. I got all the time in the world. I feel good. At least one thing a loser like you can do well is fold a bedsheet every day in the morning, the first thing when you get up. Okay. What is the second thing that you can do? The second thing that you can do, I'm just trying to keep you guessing here. What is H4? You know, this saved my life from depression. Can I try this here? Let's try it. because there's not much of space. I'm just keeping you interested. About 250 of this. Okay, takes about 2 minutes. Day before yesterday, I was in Chennai for work and my mobile phone died. And then I didn't buy a new phone. I'm using this. No WhatsApp, no email, nothing. Peaceful sleep. Once upon a time, I had started writing a journal, 100 days without a smartphone. And then the smartphone came back in my life. I'm going to show you something else. This is a Parker pen box. Alright? I created something out of it. It carries my watch. That's where the watch is. That's where the watch always will remain. And I have something else beneath. I don't have to struggle to find where my things are. I usually know where they are. There's a proverb in English, a place for everything and everything in its place. What am I trying to tell you here? H4, any guesses? Dash. I get up in the morning, I do that. Then I do this. Then I do this. I make sure when the day retires, the day gets over with this. It's all self-created. What does it tell you? H for what? Just before sleeping, I do this. I'm here. Just before sleeping, just before a nap, it is always this. Sorry, I'm presently reading this. This will always be with me. It goes here. I know of many girls who don't carry a handkerchief. And I can't believe it. Okay, this is a handkerchief. And it's a very unique handkerchief. I'm not wearing a buttoned shirt today. But it has a buttonhole. And it goes in the button. And during lunchtime, you're lawyers, right? You're going to be lawyers. You're going to be wearing white. The dal, alu, jeera, all that will fall here. So I have a handkerchief with a buttonhole. And that goes into the button, the topmost button. And I spread it out like this when I'm eating. And when I'm done, it goes back. What am I trying to tell you? And the handkerchief will always be with me. The rings will always go here. The watch will always go here. As much as possible, I wake up in the morning and I take this out. I'm trying to lead you somewhere. I have something like this to record. As soon as the next date of the case is announced, it will go wherever it is. This is 2021. Sorry, 2020. So it will just go here. What are you trying to do? What exactly are you trying to do?
There's a date already written.
Alright, there's a date already written. Alright, must be. Alright, when as soon as you... I can't show the client's dates. So as soon as you have a date, you carry this to the courtroom. It must be next to the courtroom. In my case, if my juniors are not having this next to the courtroom, there will be a couple of expletives. I'll show tantrums, I'll show airs. This has to be there. So it goes there, then and there. And I got more. This is a book where I keep accounts of which client owes me what. Okay. This is my travel pouch and I already know what is in it. Alright, let me come to the point before you get bored and run away. H for habits. Habits. You get up in the morning, it becomes your habit to fold a bed sheet. You make it a habit to keep rings in the right place. I have a lot of ladies working with me. So I know that you wear lots of rings. Some of them are precious, some of them are semi-precious, some of them are so cheap that you should not have bought it in the first place. Okay, but if you're washing your hands, the ring will be in the wash basin and you will be somewhere else. And then somebody else picks up the ring and takes it home. And then you cry, oh, wolf, wolf. Alright. It's your fault because you should not have kept the ring there in the first place. A place for everything and everything in its place. We are talking about habits. Now, why are these habits so important? Habits form your nature. Your nature becomes your character. And your character is what you are. You are what your character is. If you're a bullakkad bondu that doesn't know where you've kept your own diamond ring, what will you do when the clients check the client's papers? I feel sorry for you. If you're a person that is so shabby that you cannot fold your own bed sheet, what are you going to do with my client's papers? How are you going to be disciplined about so many things that a lawyer needs to do? Look at the writings here. When was the paper received? Where is the location of this document? Okay, and what are the instructions to be done with this paper? How will you do all of this? How will you do all of this? Somebody please put these papers back, okay? This letter comes to me. I received by who, from who, on what date, instructions. This requires a habit. The minute you get a client paper, you write. Received when? You write what are the instructions for those papers. Right? And you keep everything in its place. Have a place for everything. Alright. Build good habits. You know, if you take this and if you work with this, you will stay away from WhatsApp. If you stay away from WhatsApp and make this your best friend, you know, girls do more skipping than men. You know, your clumsy way of skipping like that in school that you used to do. This is the finest exercise. You don't need a gym. It shakes you up all top to bottom and your fat burns like crazy. As if somebody has set fire on your fat. Alright, you make this a habit every day, you won't be fat. You can eat that chocolate mousse to kingdom come and you'll still not be fat. Now, the thing about habits is like this. There's only so much space in your life.
The last problem.
Yeah, this is a habit for almost all my interns and juniors and it goes here like this. What does it do? It does this. Tell Mr. So-and-so that I'd like to see him tomorrow at 11:30. Okay. Do this, do that, do that. A junior has, you know, 100 instructions to be followed. Then when you call the junior embarrasses herself and the senior by saying, bhul gayi, bhul gaya, bhul gayi, bhul gaya, bhul gayi, bhul gaya, bhul gayi, bhul gaya. So, this goes around the neck. The minute you remember something, I mean, this can be of use to you also, take it here and just write it down and leave it, forget it. When you're sitting idle and when you're getting bored as to, now what do I do with my sorry little life? You've got lots to do. Oh, I haven't photocopied that file. Oh, I haven't researched that one particular point. Okay, so make it a habit to write down. I'm sure your mummy has asked you to buy eggs and you've forgotten it. I'm sure your papa asked you to pay the electricity bill and you stole that money. Okay, you didn't forget it, you stole the money for the boys. Make it a habit. Okay, you can forget now. You can forget forgetting because that's a habit. How about that? Now, I was making a point that in your life, there is only so much room for habits to come in. It's like that refrigerator. Okay, what do you put inside the refrigerator? First, you take out the sadila food, which you ordered from some pizza shop and you haven't eaten and that's rotting there. So that's like a bad habit. You remove that, make space and bring in a good habit. For example, there was a time when I wrote a book on quit smoking. And then I started smoking. It's one of the worst things to do. You should never take one puff of this shit. Now, this habit became so strong that it replaced this habit. Can you believe that? This tiny little shit can replace such a giant thing and destroy your life. It's not all about, you know, studies and academics and making Jack a dull boy. You can have a habit for fun too. You can have a habit for enjoyment too. You can make it a point to watch some great movie every Saturday. Saturday you can block your time, 4 p.m. to 6 p.m. and you do watch this movie. Okay, it's all about habits. Again, I'm telling you, your habit becomes your nature becomes your character, and you are what your character is. If your habits are good, if your habits are strong, your character will be strong. For example, I have a habit of going in, when I'm outside Mumbai, I have a habit of sending handwritten letters to anybody, to my clients, to my spouse, to my colleagues, and that's a great habit. You have some time, you're taking your hand and putting it to paper, so your task of composing is over, remember? And somebody's feeling so good when they receive, when they receive a letter. My colleagues write to me, when they receive a letter with this postal stamp, it feels really, really good. There's nothing, no WhatsApp or Facebook that can come close to this. I write to my clients all the time. You are nothing more than your habits. That's the point I'm trying to make. I was wanting to make this more exciting. It's not too exciting, right? I mean, this
it's
good. All right. Now, the other point that I want to make today is we are forming a garland of alphabets. Like girls, if they wear a pearl, whatever, they will wear a pearl ring, and then they'll match it with a pearl jhumka, and then a pearl shoes, and then a pearl bangle, and stuff like that. So these alphabets must be placed. Some of these alphabets go well with some of the other alphabets. All right. In law, there is something called RTW, read together with. Section so and so of this particular law read together with section so and so of this particular law read together with. Similarly, alphabet A for alarm is linked to B for books and C for compose. Alphabet H is linked to all of these. Right? You make it a point to sleep early, you make it a point to keep the alarm, you make it a point to read a book. We are talking habits. Nothing more than habits. You're not sleeping early, that's your habit. Okay, you're chatting on WhatsApp till 2:30, that's your habit, you're a loser. Your heart is broken, it deserves to be broken, such a loser you are. Okay, I'm teaching you such nice things, but you want to be stuck to your rotten phone at 2:30 a.m. in the morning with a rotten pig, a rotten swine who should not have stolen your heart in the first place. Right? You get up in the morning at 5 o'clock, you got time. In time, you can get so many things accomplished. Habit. We are moving on to the next alphabet, which according to me is the most powerful alphabet in the world. It stands for a word which is the most powerful word in the whole world. Right after this break, I'm going to come back to something. I'm going to make an announcement at the fag end of this particular alphabet, just to see how many of you watch me this long.
Your travel kit?
Yeah, I discussed the travel kit. You know that Sapna Chaudhary? The dance you watch from the beginning to the end, right? How many of you are really watching me till the end? We'll know now. Tomorrow morning, one of you will create a WhatsApp group and you will call it the Carpe Diem Club. Now, what is Carpe Diem? One of you morons must be thinking. Seize the day. I mentioned about this somewhere else. I think during the alarm alphabet, A for alarm. Seize the day. Carpe Diem in Latin stands for seize the day. 5 a.m. Alright, we'll make it 5:30. I can't make it 6 because 6 is not a wake up time. It's not sexy. It should be in the 5s. 5:15, 5:30, 5:45. 5:30, how about that? 5:30 a.m. club, and you will call it the Carpe Diem Club. CDC. One of you will create that WhatsApp group and you will add me. I'm not on WhatsApp for a few days. I'm away from it. But I want to know how many of you did this. And in that club, we will do a few activities regularly. I hope one day that club will have 1,000 young advocates. Carpe Diem Club members. Okay? 1,000 advocates will wake up at 5:30. Yeah? Let's hope so. See you for aye. Bye-bye.